First, we need to know if the data that we have is good enough. And to do this, there are two tools that I like to use. If you've looked at structured data in the past, you may remember the structured data testing tool from Google. They donated that tool to schema.org, and it's now called the Schema Markup Validator. I like this tool because it's fast and it tells me if the structured data itself is valid. It's rare for me to see any warnings on here. I usually only see when there's an error in the code because they're looking at whether or not the structured data, the code itself is valid, not whether or not Google wants it like that. That's why I also use Google's rich results testing tool. But this one takes a long time to load and I'm impatient. So the rich results testing tool shows me similar warnings and errors that you might find in your Google Search Console. So that's why it's nice to have them both. But Search Console is at best a few days behind. Both of these tools can show me at this very moment what my structured data looks like and if there are warnings or errors that I should be concerned about. They're both free and you don't need an account to use them. You can even use them on your competitors' websites if you really wanted to, if that's something you'd like to check out. Now let's talk a little bit about Search Console and Google's rich results testing tool labels. They label their search enhancements with error, valid with warnings, or valid. The error means that Google will not read that set of information in the structured data and that action is required from you. Valid with warnings means that Google can see it perfectly fine, but there may be some information you could add if you have it. And then valid, well, that means it's good. Let's talk about the valid with warnings a little bit. Valid with warnings is like a heads up. If you have the information, can you add it? If not, okay, cool. That's totally fine. There may not be any action that you have to take with valid with warnings because Google can read the information. Errors, those are the ones that you should be concerned about. When there's an error on a particular set of data, Google will ignore that whole set of data. For example, you have an error on your product's price because it's required, then Google will ignore that whole product data entirely and you won't qualify for any search enhancement from that set. So when you see errors, it's a good idea to look into them, even if you have more than one set of data, because ideally we don't want to see any errors, but maybe it's not always that simple. So if you have an error, you're going to want to talk with your theme provider or talk with your developer to help you fix it. Now, Google Search is smart though. If you have more than one set of structured data, Google will choose the most complete set of information. For example, this logo has two items detected. When you click on the logo, you're going to find that one of them is valid and the other has an error. As I mentioned, Google will ignore the set of data with the error and instead focus on the set that is valid or valid with warnings. So you could ignore this issue because you have one set of logo data that is good. Let's talk about some common warnings that we might see. The first is regarding reviews. So there are two different review fields that can be used, and both of these are optional. You should expect to see warnings for both the review and aggregate rating if you have no reviews on your product. Review companies don't always provide the structured data needed to qualify for search enhancements. Maybe that's because it's on a higher tier of their product offering, or they just don't know that it should be provided. But usually when a review provider does include the structured data for reviews, it's separate from the rest of your product data. And when they're separate pieces of information, you usually can get reviews or price and availability, but rarely all three of those, which you should be able to get. And that's one of the reasons why our app, JSON-LD for SEO, integrates with over 20 review providers. Now, if you have reviews, only the aggregate rating should be used. So you will still see that review field warning. The review field doesn't apply to Shopify products. It's for a critic review, which is where someone writes an article about maybe a business or a book or a movie. I want to expand on that a little bit Let's say you send one of your products to an influencer to write up an unbiased review. So they write up a review on their website about your product, and they say it's 4.5 stars as shown in this result for the 7 best shower tile cleaners of 2022. That is a critic review. For product reviews, you should only use aggregate ratings. The aggregate rating gathers all of the reviews for a particular product on your site, aggregates the ratings, and comes up with one final review rating. The risk of using the review field is that Google may show the reviewer's name and only show their rating instead of the aggregate of all of the reviews for that product. So then we have warnings for things like SKU and no global identifiers such as gtin or npn. These warnings show up for two possible reasons. One, you haven't set up a SKU or a global identifier for your products. Or two, your theme isn't showing the information in your structured data. If you have these set up in Shopify, make sure that you include them for all of your variants, not just the main product. If you're using Facebook, Google Merchant Center, or ads in general, you need to have the gtin or npn, as those are going to be required fields. And if you're not using Facebook Merchant Center and don't want to add this SKU, gtin, or npn, then you can just ignore these warnings. It's fine. Because again, valid with warnings, Google will still see it and they will still give you the results that you do qualify for.